update on the fun cyber symposium put together by Mike Lindell. The cyber expert that Mike Lindell claimed would help bolster his evidence for how the election was allegedly stolen from Donald Trump apparently did not deliver. Very sad. Now, this has to do with key data that allegedly underpins this theory that China hacked into the 2020 election and essentially stole the election from Donald Trump. Lindell said that he had 37 terabytes of irrefutable evidence that hackers. I know, right? 37 terabytes of irrefutable evidence that hackers, who he said were backed by China, broke into the election systems and switched votes in favor of President Biden. The proof, he said, is visible in intercepted network data or packet captures that were collected by hackers and could be unencrypted to reveal that a cyber hack occurred and that votes were switched. So what happened? What did his own cyber experts say once they had access to this data, this irrefutable data? Well, one of the cyber experts is Josh Merritt, and he said, quote, "We're not going to say that this is legitimate if we don't have confidence in the information." That's real tough. In fact, cybersecurity expert J. Kirk Weeb, I think that's how you pronounce his name, a former senior national security agency analyst, also said Lindell did not have the actual data sets. He said the scrolling text was likely meant to resemble what the packet captures would look like in the data set, but were not actual packet captures, which are vital to prove the claims. And when this information was released, when the cybersecurity experts told the American people the truth that we should have already known all along, Lindell didn't like it. He did not like that. And so here's how he reacted during his cyber symposium.
This just came out. It's Gateway Pundit. It's by Larry Johnson. And what he said, he goes, "One of Mike Lindell's cyber experts bailed on the China hack theory earlier this week and spoke with the media. Why now?" He goes down to say the cyber expert on the red team hired by Mike Lindell now says the key data underpinning the theory that China had hacked our election unveiled at the cyber symposium is illegitimate. That's a lie, okay? China did it, okay? It's a lie, so we're deflecting this lie. And we're checking into it. The red team's checking into this Larry Johnson. It sounds like he's CIA.
Lance, sounds like he's CIA. Maybe that's what the problem is. Because, you know, whenever we hear something we don't like from someone, the go-to move is to just accuse them of being part of the CIA or NATO. NATO or CIA. I don't know. Take your pick.
I thought that was a lefty thing. I don't know. I'm a bit of a boomer. 37 terabytes of irrefutable evidence. That's a lot of evidence. I don't even know that much about computers. Wow. So wait. Okay, I'm curious. Why is it China now? Wasn't it Venezuela before? Because I thought it was Venezuela that was hacking into the electoral systems that was then turning votes from from Trump to Biden. But then. Was it the FBI gets involved at that point? Like I can't keep track of all of Mike Lindell's incredible lore. The man is a one man machine. I'll say this about Mike Lindell. I don't think he's a grifter. I do not.
Really?
I think he is in the process.
He mentions his promo code for his pillows every chance he gets, including during the symposium. He's like, "I care about the sanctity of our elections. And by the way, use promo code MyPillow." I mean, come on. I mean, he might be a little bit of a grifter, but he might also genuinely think, he might genuinely believe what he's saying. It's just that he keeps talking about this evidence, but clearly he doesn't have the evidence and he knows he doesn't have the evidence. Come on.
Porque no los dos is what you're saying. Like, why not both?
Sure.
Yeah. I've heard he got dropped by Fox. They're not willing to let him advertise on there anymore. He started his own news network. Did you have the pleasure and not of watching his actual documentary, mind you? That is just like some sadomasochistic torture of which we cannot discuss on air. But the beginning of his documentary had one of the biggest legal, like, just to be completely clear, nothing what we say is actually valid or representative of any opinion held by any human in the history of the universe, like all that kind of stuff. Like, his lawyers are well aware of the journey he's gone down. I hope his shareholders are as well, because I'm guessing it's not a worker co-op pillow company.
Dude, I mean, he has shareholders. Like, I just for the first time thought of that because you mentioned it. That blows my mind. That blows my mind. That's incredible.
Can you imagine the boardroom meetings?
That is pretty incredible.
Like, you know, at Tesla, it's like, yeah, Mr. Musk, we kind of wish you hadn't, smoked all that weed with Joe Rogan. But with Mike Lindell, it's like, could you stop starting this whole news empire about, I don't know, madness? It's like, it's not a good look.
But, you know, at the same time, I remember reading about, I don't know where his business stands today in regard to sales or whatever. But business has been booming based on, you know, some of the articles I read previously, because who was ever thinking about Mike Lindell or pillows or his business until Donald Trump made him this household name? And he got opportunity after opportunity to sell his pillows to the general public. Of course, he always offers the promo code. You want to make sure you save a little money. You know, don't pay full price. Why would you do that? But I mean, maybe that's part of the reason why his business partners, his investors, his shareholders haven't abandoned him completely yet. It's also kind of miraculous that he's been able to build a business at all. And I don't mean to be. Yeah, I'm being insulting. And take it for what it is, I guess. I'm sorry, but it makes me feel kind of bad about myself that guy can build a business. You know what I mean? Like, he's built a successful pillow business.
But that's the one good thing about Mike Lindell, and that's the reason everyone loves his story, is that he is one of those people who, like, he got himself out of a terrible situation, he overcame addictions, he started this whole empire, but then at the very end of it, it's like, it's for what? And if you're talking about if it helped propel his business, I guess, is that called like the Goya effect? And if there is a Goya effect, I'd like to know what that is. Like, do we have the numbers on that? Like, how much Donald Trump and his entire like little cavalcade of ghouls, if they all buy your real products, like they've just got my pillows stacked to the back, effigies made out of my pillows and Goya beans everywhere, and that's all they eat and sleep on. Does it really help your bottom line? I think that's something I'd like to know.
Yeah, I mean, it's fascinating stuff. I do want to go to one more video from his symposium, because a lot of fun things happened. And here is one of the moments that I don't think you want to miss. Let's take a look.
Last night when I got to the hotel, I was attacked. And Phil here, we're gonna talk about where we're going today in light of this. So Colonel, go ahead.
So in addition to the red team, we started receiving credible threat warnings about 2 weeks ago.
Later, Lindell claimed that he was attacked by Antifa at his hotel. I don't believe him.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
What happened?
But Lance, how would you ever expect any type of event hosted by Trump loyalists to not mention Antifa some way, somehow? How would you not?
True.
Right?
And so what's the evidence in this case? Just word of pillow, or I don't know.
Well, actually, listen, Lance, he actually has 37 terabytes of evidence on the Antifa attacker, okay?
That reminds me of how Rudy Giuliani used to talk about cybersecurity. Like, oh, the cyber, the internet, it's everywhere. It's all around us. And you're like, yes, that technically, yeah, the cloud is a literal cloud. Thanks, Rudy. Let's keep on.
All right. Well, let's try to fit in one more story before we wrap up the show. And if you're not a member, you should totally become one. We're gonna have a great bonus episode for our members today. Click that join button or go to tyt.com/join to become a member.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.